not good. We want to play inside out. But to go on a 20-0 run to start the quarter, I mean, really took the air out of Broadneck, I thought. You know, our pressure was good. Started getting the ball inside. But I thought defensively, we got a lot of steals. Kyrie was incredible in the first half on the point of that 1-2-2. And we just made things happen. We were shooting layups and transition. That's Oakland Mills basketball. That's how we've been able to win games defensively. When you shut a team out in a championship game for 8 minutes, first 8 minutes of the game, I mean, you're playing fantastic defense. You know, as prolific as some of the scores, the best of winning team is, at the end of the day, defense wins games. And that's what we've been able to do, is shut people down. We get 0 in the first and 8.5. I mean, the look in their face said it all, man. They, you know,
what did they look like?
They looked like they were defeated, quite honestly. And I knew they had a chance to shoot their way back into the game, but we stayed with the zone because ultimately it wasn't broke, so we weren't going to fix it at halftime. So I was real happy with the turnout. Obviously, anytime I can sit my starters down for the last 5.5 minutes of the game in the championship scenario and get everyone to play and just make sure we're healthy for the next big game.
How does this prepare you for the playoffs coming up? Good or bad? I mean, it's a blowout. You know, you want a blowout.
I did not. You know, winning teams are always going to find ways to win. They were a little flat tonight. I don't know what they expected. I saw them play last week. They looked a lot tougher than that. I think they just came out a little flat, and we're not ready for all that pressure. That's a good basketball team. But, we said this before the game. This is a playoff atmosphere. This is a playoff game as far as I'm concerned. This is about getting ready for next week. And I thought the boys responded to that challenge overwhelmingly. Certainly in the first half, that was unbelievable performance defensively in that first quarter, second quarter. I couldn't be happy.
Would you say it was the best performance, first half performance of the year defensively?
We gave up 8 points. Yeah, we actually did that once before, but I would say yes. Mm-hmm. That was our best first half defensive performance of the year. There's no doubt about it.
Can you talk a little bit about Greg's performance? He had the double-double at halftime, ended up with 23 and 17, I believe.
Yeah, 7. I knew he had a lot of boards tonight. It was unbelievable. I mean, he gets around the rim within 10 feet. I saw him threw a couple in the basket, that one-hand floater. It's hard to stop. I don't care. I mean, he's 6'9", and his arms, he's a condor, if you will, with the length of his arms. He just lost that ball up. It's nothing but the bottom of the net. Once he started getting inside, it's truly over. Gravy, the icing is when he steps out and hits the three. Which, you know, we probably went to a little early today, and I thought 22 did a great job defensively on us inside. You know, the big boy's going to get his no matter what. I thought he was tremendous tonight. He changes so much of the game inside defensively. He doesn't get the block. He still alters so many shots. I thought he got every rebound when he needed to. And, you know, he starts the transition and he finishes the transition.
Is there anything that you need to improve on? I mean, you look at this game and you say, what are the things we could do better?
Sure, I thought we made a lot of sloppy turnovers. You know, I thought we didn't get to the line enough. I got to look at the film.
Okay.
An overwhelming loss. Uh-huh. It's a good victory for us. But is it a playoff scrimmage? I don't know. It's good that we got a game in. We don't have to be off for a week and a half. But the boys came out ready to play, so I mean, my hat's off to them.
You have to bring him down to earth a little bit after a game like this where it's so one-sided in the championship game.
Well, certainly our focus has been different, even just after last Thursday. Our approach to practice has been November 15, like if you could. We started over. I mean, I'm a meaner-spirited person, to put it bluntly. Obviously, I usually argue at the beginning of the season at practice. It's no nonsense. We're back to regimented time practices. Everything's to the minute, and we're working our butts off getting ready for Monday. So, I mean, that's the mentality. The regular season means nothing. At the end of the day, this game means nothing. We're starting over. The real season starts for us Monday, so that's what it's about.
Would you prefer to have a loss, though? I mean, now it's kind of a different pressure. You guys are undefeated now. It's kind of like all the chips are verbal, you know, proverbially are in now.
I agree. Interesting. You know, you get to 13, 14, 15 games, and you're wondering when are we going to get that loss, especially in Howard County, in a given night. You know, you come out flat, but as we get, the streak got higher and higher, it got to the point where, you know, boys didn't want to lose. Mm-hmm. Quite frankly, I didn't want to lose. Mm-hmm. Is that going to come to haunt us later? Maybe. But like that said, we've been focusing on that part of the season is over. Mm-hmm. And tonight was something new. And it means nothing. And that's what we've been talking about all week. 22 games, 23 games, it doesn't mean a damn thing. Mm-hmm. And that's something I'm hammering home every day on a consistent basis. Mm-hmm. And we just got to come out one game at a time, one play at a time, and get into our rhythm and do what we do best. And that's get up and go and play defense. So, the streak is the streak, but who cares at the end of the day?
Right.